Hello everyone. Hello everyone. We are starting in few minutes. We are just waiting for more candidates to join. If you have any doubt, please write in the question and answer box. We have to wait only few minutes. Am I audible? Vijay sir, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. So, welcome all in the today's second session, second day of the event on advancement of Excel in research. I would like to invite our respected chairperson of today's session, Dr. Atul Babbar. Atul Babbar is presently working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department of SGTU University. He has completed his PhD degree in mechanical engineering from Harvard Institute of Engineering and Technology. He completed his M.Tech from GNDU Engineering College, Ludhiana, in 2016 with silver medal in academics. He graduated in 2014 mechanical engineering honors from Delhi Professional University. He has been teaching student academic and research. He is a level 2 non-destructive test engineering engineer certified by American Society of Non-Destructive Testing. His research interests include biomedical 3D, 4D printing, conventional, non-conventional machines, and non-limited to that. He has authored more than 30 research articles and book chapters in various international journals and national journal, SCI and Scopus journals. He has been reviewing this research article of various peer review SCI and Scopus journal. So please, welcome to Mr. Dr. Atul Babbar. Please, sir, can you start the session?
Thank you, Ravi. Thank you, Dr. Ravi, sir, for introducing me to the panel, all panelists and panelists. And good afternoon to all of you. And we are here for a day two of our workshop on graph technology and some specific tools in research. And today's topic will be presented by Mr. Arko. He is an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering in SGTU University. The topic of today's discussion is advancement of Excel in research. And first, I would like to introduce Mr. Arko Bagchi. And Mr. Arko Bagchi is an assistant professor in computer science and engineering department at the Faculty of Engineering Technology. He has more than 10 years of experience in teaching and years in IT industry. And he is 20% PhD from the Gurugram University in machine learning, Excel system, artificial intelligence, in the field of agriculture. He has completed his M.Tech B.Tech from West Vietnam University. And furthermore, Mr. Bagchi sharpened his career further with an additional qualification as he and a postgraduate diploma in business management. And he worked in Delhi Professional University as assistant professor in computer science department. He worked also as a course coordinator, chief examiner, syllabus reviewer, and he was the head of computer science department of Delhi College of Technology, CTE, and Global Institute of Technology and Management in the last 4 years. Professionally, talking about Mr. Arko Bagchi, SAP Certified Application Associate in Business Intelligence and Certified Language Professional. Hailing from West Bengal, Mr. Arko Bagchi is an active researcher in the field of quantum computing, reverse computing, and data mining, big data, and artificial intelligence. Some of his expert areas. So, Mr. Bagchi has guided more than 30 students for the dissertation and 50 plus B.Tech. And minor projects guided students for fixing and company content projects with a wide range of applications like files, web, store. So, under his supervision and guidance, students participated and selected in Smart India Hackathon 2017 from DCPN, from third prize from EITM SIH 2019, and from SD University, or SGTU University. And furthermore, Mr. Arko has 10 publications in national and international. And with many conferences activities. So I would like to invite Mr. Arko Bagchi for introducing the topic of today's discussion to our panel as well as and is present from all over the differences. So I would request Mr. Arko Bagchi to start the topic of the present day two. Yes, Arko sir. Arko sir, thank you for joining us. We can start our discussion of advancement of excellent research so that our panelists and attendees can get to learn the wide range of information from your expertise and from your knowledge. Thank you once again, sir, for giving us your time. We can start with the discussion. We are waiting for expert knowledge.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you, Atul, sir, for nicely introducing me. So today's topic is the advancement in Excel. I cannot share the content. When I share the content, it is disabled, sir. Yeah. So today's topic is, just a minute, I need to share the content. So advancement of Excel in research. So I would like to say a few words regarding the Excel and the research. What we do in research in, what it will excel in research. See, in research, there are a lot of activities involved, which we need to do manually, or you can say mathematically, or you can say that is the, we need to do it in various way. That is actually the research. And research is actually not only finding the ultimate solution and all these things. We need to do some calculations, and we need to focus on particular problems to find a solution. That is actually the research. And in this research, there are a lot of technology or techniques included. Okay. So first of all, I would like to say that there are a lot of tools available for research. Then why Excel? See, we have this popular software called SPSS, statistics, that is also used in research for the statistical evaluation and mathematical evaluation purpose. But in Excel also, you can also do these things very efficiently. That is one of the, you can say, major thing, that the beauty of the Excel. And another thing is Excel, comes in every system. I mean, everyone is having laptop or desktop or operating system is must have the Excel. But the other softwares you need to purchase, and they are also, you can say, some kind of heavy, or it's a kind of taking some load into your system. But Excel is very lightweight, and it is coming with your operating system so that it is very easy to use also. So these are the, you can say, the most important feature why we use the Excel. Okay. Now moving into the next part, that is the advancement in Excel. I would just like to say some basic operations first. Everyone is having expertise in Excel because every, you can say, work in currently in industries and everywhere is done into Excel. We are calling this Excel, but actually the main name for this software is the spreadsheet. Okay, so this is a spreadsheet application, and there are a lot of, you can say, a lot of things you can do with the spreadsheet software. So this is very important to know what the spreadsheet software actually does. See, for example, in a company, what the higher authorities actually wants, their main purpose is to get the result, end result, and to make the forecast with the particular data from that particular result. So they need to forecast based on some data, based on some analysis, and that analysis can be done in the Excel very efficiently. That's why in every organization, Excel is being used. That is the main purpose of Excel. So today, before going into the deeper into the advancement of what we can do to support our research, I would like to discuss these basic functions, which may be known to you, but some of the, a tricky part I need to, I will let you know that you can do it with Excel to, very efficiently do your research purpose, okay? But before that, I'll just share the any Excel screen. I'll just do it in a practical way. I'll show you how to do this. First of all, I'm just cutting into, I mean, I'm just cutting all those basic operations, that is the dragging, dropping, and all these things, what you can do in your Excel. I'm just moving into that part. That is, known to everyone, okay? So coming into the next part, just let me share my Excel screen. Is it visible?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
It's visible? Okay, fine. So as you can see, this is the Excel screen. Everyone is, very much familiar with this.
PPT is only visible, sir.
PPT is visible. My screen is not visible. Excel screen is not visible. Okay. Now it's visible.
No, sir, from my side, sir.
Okay, I'll just do one thing. I just share entire screen. Is it visible now?
No, sir, it's not visible.
I don't know. I'm sharing the container.
We can see your PPT PowerPoint presentation, but we are not able to see spreadsheet.
Okay. So I'll just share my entire screen, but that is, can you see the screen?
No, sir.
That is also not visible.
You can do one thing, just stop the sharing, then again share.
I'm not sharing right now. It is not showing not anything I have shared. Yeah. Now. I think now it is showing, right? Can you see the Excel right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Excel sheet.
Okay, very good. So this is a blank Excel sheet, okay? Now this blank Excel sheet, I just make you understand what we can do with this. I'll just, this is Excel, Office 365 and Microsoft Office 2016 or 19 edition. You will find most of the interface will be same. Now I'm just moving ahead, because all these are known by all, that is the font, wrap text, merge center, every tool in here, everyone knows these things, okay? Conditional formatting, format table, cells, everything, insert, delete, okay? It is the home part. In the insert also, there are some charts, bars, that is also, I'll be explaining this, what is this, okay? And then page layout, formula, this is also required by researchers when you are writing your thesis or something, or you can write on some project. Then coming into the data part, it is very important. I'll just show you what you can do with this data part, okay? Now, in this particular case, for example, I just wanted to show you in the first slide, that is a sum. Everyone knows what is this sum. For example, say random numbers 12, 34, I can say 56, that is a kind of random number we can see in here. Now for this sum, everyone I think familiar with this, that if we can drag into this in our this area, can you see my cursor? There are automatically giving you the value, that is average 39, sum 158 and count 4. Okay, so this is the basic you can say operation in Excel, what you can do the sum and do this and calculating average and all these things. Okay, now these things you can also do it by formula. I think you are all knowing by formula. You can formula, put the formula by typing only equal to, okay, and in I'm just showing you the sum. Sum will be our formula here, and then showing number one, number two. So for example, this one, I'll just if I want to sum with these two numbers and enter a bracket is closed, and then it will show you the sum. You can do it horizontally, vertically, whatever you do. I mean, it will be your choice, but you can use this sum function in this way. Okay. Now, there is also another shortcut for sum that is called alt equal to. If you put alt plus equal to, if you press like alt equal to, it will automatically give you the sum. For example, if you have 34 here you have 56, 12, and you just want to do the sum. Okay, so in this particular case, if you put alt equal to, then it will automatically select this fields 34, 56, 12, and it will give you the sum. Now, similarly, if these cells are also filled with data like this way, you can simply drag and your sum will be there. So this is very basic sum. Okay. Sum if, there is also another function is called sum if. If I want to use the sum, for example, 56, 64, I just want sum if first it is the range. Okay, I'm just giving you this range, then the criteria. Okay, criteria will be like I want to do the sum what is greater than 50 or equal to 56, for example. Okay, so I'll give this 56. And then the sum range. So basically, the sum if is not widely used here, but I just showed you this thing that sum if you want to calculate this, I mean specific values, and if you want to omit the specific values, then sum if will be applicable for that. Okay. Another is flash fill. It is the prerequisite of your research purpose. That is, if you have the lot of data you want to separate with the, you can say, common separated value, that is called the flash fill. Okay, I can my screen is visible or only this one? Excel sheet is visible. I want to share my screen, entire screen. Is it visible?
No sir, right now nothing is visible. Yes,
I think it is visible now. Okay, yeah, so okay, so the flash fill and what is this separated values by delimiter, I'll just show you how you can separate things if you have a particular data. Sometimes we also have some data we got from various internet sources and all other sources. We have got entire data with by only CSV file, that is the comma separated values. Okay, now how you can identify that particular file and you can split that file, I'll just show you. Here is a kind of data set, as you can see, that email. Okay, this email is having some name dot, dot another name at the rate gmail.com. So what I'll do, I'll just take the entire email. Okay, I want that this should be separated. Sometimes it is needed that if you want to do the first name and last name, then what to do in this particular case, if you want to say, for example, first name and then last name, if your email ID is having this kind of, you can say, formatted first name and last name. So what to do, you just type your first one in copy and do this one test. Okay, and then what to do, then if you can do with this, press Control E. Okay. As you can see, by pressing Control E, all the first name field is coming into your first name. Okay. And the same way, if you are writing, just write this one, Goodwin. Okay. Now go to the next cell and press Control E. And it is separated. Okay. So in this way, you can separate your comma or dot, anything you have the delimiter, you can just separate the values. Okay. These things also can be done by go to flash fill, I mean fill, then flash fill. This, I mean, the function is same, only it is done by the clicking. And what I showed you, that is the shortcut key. If you do the flash fill, same thing will be happening, that your data will be dividing. Okay. Next, coming into transpose, I think transpose is known by all, that is if like this 1, 2, 3, 4 in this way, if this is vertically there, if I'm copying this thing, and if I want to paste this, I have to use Control Alt V. Control Alt V is actually giving you the paste special, dialog box where you can use the transpose. Okay, the transpose is actually putting the data, if you are copying horizontally, it will be putting into vertically. Okay, so this is the transpose. This is very common, you can say, functions to all. Okay, short and filter, nothing to explain much, in detail. There's a short function, as in this particular data set, say for example, there is a column called, just a minute, there's a column called salary or zip, whatever it is. I think it is, you know, that you just select the column, go to the short and filter. If there is a, option for filter and short also, smallest to largest. Okay. So if you do this largest, it will ask you expand the selection. If you click on yes, it will be shorted in this way. Okay. So shorting is there. Next, tables. Tables are having some tricky part. That's why I just put it in here. Now, what table does, for example, if I have some data, fruit data, for example, there are fruits data, mango, there are the fruits, okay? Now, if I want to make it a table, then what shall I do? I'll just select it and press Control T. Okay. Now table with the data. If you press Control T, then it will ask you the data, as I have selected this data. So it will be a table. So creating a table like this, a table will be created. Now after this table creation, it will be acting like a data. Data, you can say data set or list like, okay. Now, what is the utility of this particular table? Say, for example, I'm just copying this one. There's the fruits, okay. So these are the fruits I want, that every cell will be showing as a list. Now, as you have seen also, there are large sheet where you just want specific data. For some reasons, for example, if a particular student, you want to fill a particular form where the stream is there, okay, and you want that 500 students will be writing or inserting their stream, only stream will be there. So only one stream, CS or CSE, that will be entered by the students in various way. Someone might write CS, someone might write CSE in this way. Okay, but if you want that they must write whatever you want, you must put a list there. Okay, so in this particular case, fruit, okay, you want that these cells will have those data only you have created in the fruit section, another sheet or another table. Okay, so you have selected this one, then go to data and go to data validation. Okay, now this data validation, click on the validation, and this is dialog box is coming the allow. Now you have to select the list. Okay, now the list is there and it will ask you for the source. Click on the source, I mean that particular button, and select this. Okay, so it will automatically select you the range, then close it and click on OK. Now as you can see here, a list, a particular drop down box is created where all these fruits are there. Okay, now click on this and find this one. So there is no chance of getting error. Whatever you want, you have to, I mean, you can get it here. Okay, so this is also another small tip from Excel. Now drop down, and next one is data import. Sometimes what happens if you want to, I mean, gather some data, I mean, data sets are also available in internet. There are a lot of websites like Google Dataset, Kaggle. Okay, there are a lot of data sites available where you can find freely data set. Okay, large number of data sets are there in the internet. But sometimes what happens, you are seeing some data which is over internet, you just want to import it in your Excel. So generally what you do, you just do the copy and paste. Okay, for example, I think my screen is visible. So here is the data. Okay, so for example, here's the data from internet, www.census2011.co.in, district wise data, the population growth, sex ratio and literacy. Now I want this data. So generally what I can do, I can use, I mean, select this one like this. I just copy and open another Excel. Okay, and then I can paste it here. So I can see the data, but there might be some kind of error, or there are some hidden, you can say, list also, or Excel will be like having also that particular reference. Whenever I'm clicking that particular Excel file, it is redirecting me to the website. So this is not look like what I want. So what I'll do, I'll just use get data in the data function. So I'll show you how to do that. Go to get data. Okay, and here lot of the data sources are available. Sometimes you get the data set in CSV, so you can import the data from CSV. If you have the data in XML format or JSON format, or if your data is having in a folder, that also you can import. Now if your data is a database, so that is used in a previous database or the DBMS software like Microsoft Access, MS SQL, or you can say Oracle. So there are a lot of databases also supported in Excel where you can import your data. Okay, now import, that means it's a very useful feature. That means you have the connection from that another data source to your Excel data. So that means you can import your data into your Excel sources. So from SAP HANA database also you can import the data, from cloud also, from Azure's. Okay, from online services there are a lot of, I mean, sources available. So I'll just demonstrate only one thing, that is the other sources. In other sources, if you want some internet data, because mostly we researchers, what we do, we just find the data. Okay, and from that particular data, whatever we are, I mean, finding in the internet, we just want to, I mean, copy and paste into our Excel, then we want to do the analysis. So data from web is very important. Okay, now if you have to click from web. Okay, now click on this one. Now it is actually it want your URL. Copy this one, copy, and then paste it here. Click on OK. And if you have active internet connection, it will fetch all the data. Not only it will fetch the data, it will be showing you all other tables on that particular website. Okay, I'm sure some of you have used this particular feature. So we can see in this particular website, we have two tables, the document one table and the table zero. Okay. Now this table zero is having all the data I want, and that is the editable format. There is no such kind of reference will be there or link will be there. Okay. Now there are two things you can do. You can do load from directly here, or you can change the data. For example, you want that your data will be changed. You want to edit the data. So first of all, if you want to transform the data or change the data, you can use this Excel query. Now transform the data, if you click on that one, it will be opening into the Power Query editor. So where you can change the data, and in this particular source, this pane, the steps what you have applied, it will be showing here. So if any you can say steps you have missed, or in any steps you have done something wrong, you can you have the option to go back previously. Okay, so if you want to change some data in here, you can change it. For example, you know that this is a data, I mean zero, but you know the value. So see, in this particular case, it is 938. Okay, you want to change it. So you can also change any column in here. After changing, okay, after changing, you just close and load. So this is the first step. Where we, if you load, that will go to directly to your Excel. And if you want to change it, then from here you need to do the close and load. Now, if you do this one, it will be showing you exactly what you wanted the data. So in this way, if data set is not available in a proper format like CSV or you can say Excel format, it is only displaying in the web page. You can also import the data from web page itself in your Excel. Okay, this is also one kind of useful, handy feature. Is very important for your research purpose. Conditional formatting, that is also, I think all knows what happens in this particular case, that conditional formatting is there. We have, I'm not going into deeper into this, we have some kind of rule. Okay, on that particular rule will be applied into the cell, like if the cell value is greater than 50, that will be highlighted. Okay, if the cell value is between 50 to 60, it will be highlighted. So this is how the conditional formatting will happen. Okay, highlight cells, that is the rule, like greater than, less than, between, equal to, it happens. Okay, then you want to highlight the top 10 items, bottom 10 items, the rule is there. So it's also useful when you have some kind of you are using some highlighting feature. Okay, pivot table, that is also another useful you can say feature. It is sometimes very useful when you are doing the analysis part. Okay, so what is this pivot table? Here you can analyze like a database or DBMS, like a query. You can analyze your data. I have a particular data set, for example, here. I'll just show you. Here is the data. This is the data. What you can do in this particular data, you can analyze the data with the pivot table. Okay. Now for this one, what you need to do, you have to go to insert, click on insert, and you have the pivot table. Now this is a normal table you are having, only columns and rows. You have to convert it first into the pivot table, and then you can use the dashboard, or you can create the dashboard, or you can create the chart and all these things. Okay, so first of all, this particular table has to be converted into the pivot table. So click on the pivot table, and it will ask you the range. Now by default, this whole table is selected. As you can see, sales data from A1, dollar A1, this is the A1 cell, to 2156, lot of data in here. So it is all selected. Okay, now here are the two options, if whether you want to use it in the existing worksheet or in the next worksheet. So I'm using new worksheet. Okay, so whenever you click on OK, as you can see, your table is being converted into some kind of analysis tool, or you can say analysis table, which is called the pivot table, where you can exactly find what are the columns available, and you can analyze with the help of this column. So for example, you want that what was the quantity year wise, you just want to display. So you click on years and you click on quantity. So it will show you in 1994, the total quantity was 7318. Okay, in 1995, this 1996, this. So in this way, you can actually analyze the whole, I mean, details of a particular data set you are having in different way. Okay, so this is what the sum value is actually showing in here. In 1994, some of the quantity will be there in the order date wise, 1995 date wise. Now here is rows and values. You can also drag this particular field in here also, for example, product name. So here the product name is also will be displayed. So you can click on here and or you can drag it into rows and columns filter also. You can create the filter. It is a kind of similar thing what we do in the business intelligence. In the business intelligence, you are having the slicing, dicing, and you are actually seeing the result in a different angle. For example, in SAP, there was some concept in cube. So that is a multi-dimensional analysis. So you can do this analysis into this Excel also. So it's a very useful feature. Okay, fine. Now, another thing, product order date, years, I just want what is the quantity, and this will be used as a chart. So you can use, select this one and click on the charts. So we'll having all the details in this particular case. So I'm just selecting the line chart. So we'll have the line chart here. As you can see, in the year wise data we can find. Okay, so this is all the years selected. Now, if you want that, you just need to decorate this particular graph in a way, you can click on this, like date level will be also there. Okay, if you click on trade line, there will line for whether it is going up or going down linear, it will show you. So there are a lot of options there where you can, I mean, easily visualize your data. Sometimes visualization is also very important. So there are a lot of other different softwares also for visualization purpose, for analysis purpose. But in Excel also, it's so powerful, you can do it in one place. Okay, so next, coming into the next part, that is the statistical analysis what we do in the Excel. This is the most important part where you are actually you require actually in your research. Okay, so these are the primary thing what you need to do in whatever you are doing in your research. Okay, so in the first one, in the first phase of your research, that is research methodology, you just do this, and there you are actually using some kind of, you can say, various kind of test, I mean data gathering, the testing and all these things. Okay, so the statistics will be there. So it is also very important for Excel that you can do this kind of analysis with Excel. Okay, so let's go to the a simple data set is there. But before starting this, what are these things? Average, mode, median, standard deviation, large, small. These things are very much required in case of the descriptive statistics. Okay, so this is very important when you do the descriptive statistics analysis. These are also like a functions are available in Excel. Like average, we have the, say for example, if you want to do the average, we have average function. Okay, if you want to use, next is mode, which is large or small, that is also median, that is also you can do median function, you can also use. Okay, standard deviation is also can be used in here by the formula. Okay, so standard deviation dot p dot s, this is for the sample size. Okay, the calculate standard deviation based on the entire population. If you have entire population, you want to calculate the standard deviation, then dot p will be used. For dot s, if you're you are using some samples, then you have to use the dot s function, and this is how these two are actually used in this particular case. Okay, so it's very important. But what happens if I just don't want to, and large and small will be there also. That is, I'll just show you what is large and small will do. That is also large function is there. Now large function, what it does, for example, if I have n number of employee in office, okay, and we are providing the salary. For example, here I have a data set like here. Salary will be there. Okay, so this is the salary column. Now if you want that your salary, you want to display the largest salary, okay, who is the highest paid, or the lowest salary, or the second largest, or the second lowest, so you have to use that large function. Okay, and for lowest salary, if you want to display that, that is the small function. Is very useful when you actually use this large and small. Okay, so this is, you can also do it in with the function. Now in Excel there are also additional pack is there, which is called the data analysis tool pack. Okay, in this tool pack there are a lot of add-on packages are available, in which you can do this analysis in a statistical way, or you can see you can use the statistical test or formulas. Okay, so for that one, what you need to do, you have to first activate it. By default it is not activated, you have to first activate. So first of all, you have to go to the Excel option. Okay, now this is the Excel option.
Arko sir, there Hello? Is some problem. Hello? Yes, you are audible now, sir.
I'm audible.
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. So you have to go to the Excel option and then click on the add-ins. Okay, in the add-ins you will find this one, manage add-ins. Okay, there are a lot of options here also. There is the Excel add-ins, com add-ins, action. You have to choose the Excel add-ins. Okay, and then click on go. So if you are clicking on go, then you can see there are a lot of add-ins available, which is the analysis tool pack VBA, euro currency, solver add-ins, all these are available. Okay, so you have to click this analysis tool pack. This is important step. Without enabling this additional analysis tool pack, we will not be able to do the analysis. That's the main thing. Okay, now this analysis tool pack, whenever you clicking this one, and you can also use the solver add-ins if you require, not required, only this one is required. Okay, click on OK. Now if you click on OK, nothing will happen, but in case of the data, in the data tab, you will see another option is available, that is the data analysis. Okay, now in the data analysis, if you click on this, so you will see what are the analysis pack you have, that is the ANOVA single factor, ANOVA two factor with replication, two factors with the replication, correlation, covariance, descriptive statistics, exponential smoothing, F test, Fourier analysis, histogram, okay, moving average, sampling, regression, all the test you need, that is in here. T test, okay, paired T test two sample assuming. So these will be available. And another thing I just want to share with you, that is, if you require this test in a specific, you can say, situation. So if you want to use this kind data analysis add-ins, you have to use in a specific way. For example, in this particular small data set I have just used, that is the temperature, price of ice cream and units sold. Okay, so if I want to do the descriptive statistics, okay, now what we need to do, just a minute, I'm just having a question. Just a minute, let me see the question. We will have the question answer session later, I think, okay, because there will be a problem with to view all the questions right now. So if you have any question, I'll just repeat once again. If you have any question, just note it down, and later on we will be discussing on that, okay. Yes, someone is raising hands. Okay, so question is there. Yeah, I'll be here T test. Yeah, I'll be showing all the tests here. Up to the time. I don't know how many tests I can cover up, but I'll be showing you how to use those tests. Okay, with the data set. Please repeat how to add data analysis feature. Okay, fine. I'll just repeating how to add this kind of feature. My screen is visible. Hello.
No, sir. Your screen is not visible.
Now it's visible.
Yes. Now it's visible.
Okay. Fine. So what I'll do, I'll just share. Let me show you how you can add this Excel analysis tool pack. That was the question. You just go. You can click on this ribbon. Okay. Customize the quick access toolbar. From here you can go to more commands, okay, then you can also again you can go to the file. Okay, in the file there is an option, you can go from here also, whatever process you can follow, go to file, go to option, and you will find the Excel option. Or else you can also go to this particular ribbon, more commands, you will find the option. So anyhow, you have to reach to the option, that is the file, then option, and then add-ins, the second last add-ins. Then after that, you have to select Excel add-in, then click on go. Okay, then you will find this analysis tool pack. By default, it is not actually selected, you have to select it, okay. Now after the selection, go to the data section, you will find this data analysis. So this is the first step what you need to do if you want to do the analysis part in Excel. Okay, now here is a simple data set we are having. Now we will be demonstrating the descriptive statistics. Okay, now go to the data analysis. First of all, in this particular case Excel, I don't know how many of you have used SPSS, but SPSS session will be there also. So these two, SPSS and Excel, does the same job, but in case of the visualization factor, SPSS will be far more than Excel. And there, in Excel, it will be only visible in your sheet, and it will not be producing that much of detail you can say visualization at a glance. You have to, I mean, design it accordingly. Okay, so for example, if you want the output, first you have to select the where you want to see the output. Okay, so for example, I'm clicking this cell, so my output will be here. So I'm clicking this cell. So first of all, you have a data set. You will click on a cell, then go to data analysis. Okay, now we wanted to do the descriptive statistics. Now in the descriptive statistics, select it and click on OK. Okay, now it will ask you the input range. Now your input range is this. Now you can use in this way. Now there is a two option. Option one, you can, your data is starting from this particular cell. Okay, your data is here, and the first particular row is your heading. That is the labels. So if you are selecting as a whole like this, okay, you have to check this one, labels in the first row. This is very important. Otherwise, it will be showing the error. So in the columns, the first row will be your labels. That is also important thing. But if you don't want to check it, just don't select it. Okay. You just select only your data. Then you don't need to use this one. Okay, but if you are selecting in this way, labels to one, okay, and output will be a new workbook in where your output will be. That is the main question. And here I have selected this one. Okay, if you click on OK, the error was I need to select what I need to display, and here are what we need to display. That is the summary statistics, confidence level of mean. What will be the confidence level? That will be also showing in here. Okay, kth level, kth smallest, these things will be showing. So I'll just tick on this one. Okay, now click on OK. It is showing me in a new sheet. Here is the my data. It is showing the sheet one because I have selected in this particular data must be showing into new sheet. Okay, do it again. Data analysis, descriptive statistics, click on OK, select this. When the range, just delete the range, or you just manually use this one. Okay, now select it. Don't use this one, new worksheet. Use this one, output range. So output range is like this one. Okay, now click on OK. This is E6 cell. Click on this one. This one is your output range. So your data is showing in here. Now, what is the information I'm getting in here? The mean. What I just told you, that these are the main thing you need to, I mean, evaluate when you are doing the statistical analysis, the mean, median, standard deviation. So we can find the mean in here, the mean temperature, price of ice cream, the mean unit sold, standard error, median, okay, mode, standard deviation, sample variance. Okay, you can say the counts, confidence level is also there. So that means in this particular analysis, you can have all the descriptive statistics here for this particular data set. Okay, so this is a very useful feature for Excel. Like this, we're also having other, you can say, statistical methods also to demonstrate. Okay, I think my screen is not visible right now, right? Hello. Is it visible?
Sir, your screen is not visible.
There is some problem in internet. I think that's why again and again it is.
Stop sharing and then try to reach.
Yeah. I just did that. I just did that.
Yes. Now okay. It's visible.
Now it's visible. Okay. Yes, so yes. I think this is the thing every researcher might be requiring. If you do the hypothesis testing, first you have to use the null hypothesis, then alternate hypothesis. Then if null hypothesis is there, then you have to do the hypothesis testing, and then the statistical tests will be there. And there are two types of tests, the parametric and parametric, and the, in the parametric test, we have Z test, T test, F test, and all. So I'm not going into deeper in this test because this is not the session for analyzing those tests. Okay, I just want to show you how you can perform this test into Excel. So that's what we need to do. So in this case also, say for example, this is a histogram, one of the, you can say another thing, that is the histogram. I'll be showing you the regression, sampling, standard deviation, everything. I'll be showing that histogram. So for example, other correlation, whatever you need. Now this thing, go to the data analysis. Okay. And this is the histogram we have. You can have all the data set. I mean, you just download the data set from any, I mean, website, or if you have created the data set by your own, that's also very good. So you can, I mean, play with all those data set, how you can perform this test. Okay. Now this histogram, now this input range, okay, and the bin range. So input range is like my, this one, temperature. And first one is level. And for the bin range also. I have this bin range. Now this output range, you have to select any cell here, like I have selected here. Okay, now what you want to do? That's the shorted histogram, cumulative percentage, and the chart output. Let's do the all these things. Okay, so what will happen if you do this one? You can have the frequency of 20. See, in the temperature, that frequency of 20 will be like two times here, 20 and 20, and the frequency of, and the bin is 20. So the frequency is 2, frequency of 30 will be 3, and 45, and so on. Okay, now this is what we can do in the histogram. Now this histogram, as you can see, the frequency of 20, frequency of 50, frequency of 40 is like this. And if you want to decorate this one, you can click this data table. Okay, it will show you the error bars, grid lines also. Okay, so these are the decorative feature, or you can see the detailed description of the chart, whatever you want in this particular case. Okay, if you want to do the colors also, you can, but in this case, this is not happening. In other charts, you can do the colors and filters also in your chart. Okay, so this is the histogram. Now, what is the standard deviation? Standard deviation, that means we have this number and score in here. We need to calculate the standard deviation. So in Excel also, is options are available, like go to data analysis and where from the histogram is taken. Okay, so I'll just another question is where from the histogram is taken. So in the histogram, as you can see, so if I'll just make it very simple. Step one, you need to activate the analysis tool pack. Step two, You just import the data set, or you just take the data set, whatever you want. Okay, you have the data set is like this. I just created a random data set like this, a small data set. You just select the data set. That means it is selection. Okay, select the data sets and go to this data. Okay, and then go to data analysis. Now in the data analysis, you will be finding all those. Okay, fine. So all these things, okay. And then here you can find the regression also. I think you have got your answer. Okay, and after that, we can see these charts and all these things. Okay. Now we have completed this one, descriptive statistics, regression. Let's do the regression also. So in the data analysis, the regression is there. Okay. So if you want to the regression analysis, you can also do that in Excel. Like click on the regression, click on OK, and then the input Y range and input X range will be there. So I'll just see this one temperature, and I can see why you need sold. Okay. So in the next new sheet, it is displaying the result. What I'll do, I can use the output range. The output range will be like this. Just click on anywhere in your sheet, okay? And then use plots. Use the confidence levels, okay? So here we have the plots and the summary output. What I was taking, I took these two, temperature and unit sold, okay? So you can see the regression statistics will be there, the multiple R value is there, R square, and this particular calculations are so accurate. Whatever you do in the pen on paper, you apply the formula, okay, and you can find this this results are same. Okay, now this ANOVA is also there, analysis of variance. ANOVA is also there, the significance of F and residual total, all this you can say details are showing in here. So I had this six observe here. I had this observation in six, predicted 20. All the results are there. I think it is, I can identify whoever has studied this particular, I can say the theory, they can relate with this one. As you can see, this is the test. Again, I'm saying we are not here to discuss all this test type. What is Z test? What is T test? What is F test? We are not actually discussing this one. I'm here just to show you how to analyze or how to do that. Okay. Same thing you can do within SPSS also. There, that is also, a very useful handy tool, but that is a kind of heavy software and that is pricey also. That's why Excel is comparatively used by all. Most of the concept people are using Excel for that purpose. Okay, so we have this entire regression analysis. Okay, now another two, we can do the correlation. Now the correlation, I think we know that what is this correlation? Correlation between two variables. I think we already have already known that what is dependent variable, independent variables. I'm not going into that part because that is another thing. We are not doing it statistics class. Okay, so in here in the correlation, that means there's a correlation of temperature and unit sold. So this is the temperature and the unit sold. We want to calculate the correlation between these two variables. Okay. and correlation of temperature and price of the ice cream. Okay. So what we need to do, go to data analysis. Here we have the correlation. Okay. We can also use the correlation, then click on OK. The input range. Okay. In the input range, levels in the first row, we're having output range will be here. This is our output range, okay, and the input range. Just a minute.
Arko sir, there is some problem with your voice.
Hello. Atul sir.
Am I audible?
Arko sir, you are audible now.
Okay, I think there was a network problem. I'm audible now, no?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay, fine. I just shared.
And sir, there is some question in the question box. There are some
I cannot access that one. I don't know why, but it is coming into a small box. I cannot access that one. That's why it is. I cannot access that one.
So you can present your presentation later on. I have noted all the questions from participants, and we will discuss it later at the end of this session.
Okay, fine, no problem. And then. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Okay. So I was just talking about this one correlation. Okay. So this, I mean, I don't know how much it was visible. So I'm starting from the scratch. So correlation of this two variables, that is the temperature and the unit sold, will be there. Okay. So in this particular case, what we do, we need to use the correlation function here. As we have already told that these analysis, whatever we require, whatever we do, we have the function in here. Okay. So this function can be applied into this, you can say, this data also. Okay. So for the application of the function, we have this fx, as we know that, okay, the insert a function, or what we do, we can use the equal to function. That is, I don't know, some question was there popping up. Can you please tell me what was the question, sir? Atul sir.
Yes, sir. Few participants have asked certain questions. First, it is where we can open data tab.
Where we can open data tab.
Data tab.
Okay. Okay. This data tab is actually in your this upper tab. It is by default there. Okay. Now, when in the data tab, I just show you one thing. First of all, again, if go to this add-ins, go to action and remove this analysis tool pack. Okay. Now, as I remove, see, whenever I'm going into the data tab, there is no such tab is there, data analysis. You don't find any tab like this. Okay. Now, if you are in data tab, in the formulas, data review, in the upper the data tab, here, if you again go to the option and you just go to add-ins, Excel add-ins, you just click on this. I'm in the data tab. Now see this one, the data analysis is there. Okay, so from where it is actually showing. I hope I can, I answered your question. If not, please, you can write your question, as I cannot able to see you. Atul sir will be telling me the question. Sir, I think I have answered the question, right? That was the question, where is the data tab?
Yes, this is
okay. Okay, fine.
Second, we have, what is the importance of average in Excel?
What is the importance of average?
Average.
Sir, what is the importance of average in Excel? That is, if you want that, you have to do the average. Average is a function you can use everywhere whenever it is needed. Okay, for example, I have this unit sold. Okay, now I just want that, what is the average unit sold? Now there are certain ways to do that in the Excel. There is a very handy way that if you just select on this, you can find the here average 16, count 7, and sum is 112. So if you have the data, you can have the average count right your way. Okay. So that is the main purpose. Now, what is the purpose of making the average? That is up to your choice. Up to your requirement. Say, for example, in our system, what happens if we are conducting 3 tests? Now the rule is you have to take the average of 3 tests. Okay, there you need to do the average. Okay, so this is why we need the average. And in the average, you can also just drag in and from here. Otherwise, we have the average function also. You can see this is the average function, sum, average. These are the very useful function, and we always need that. Okay, now the correlation, I was talking about the correlation between these two. You need to insert a function of the correlation, like the insert function. You have to search for correlation function. This is the correlation function. Okay. Now returns the correlation coefficient between two data sets. So this is the correlation function you need. So you just have to insert the function correlation, and then you need array one and array two. For example, here the two variables are the temperature and unit sold. For example, that is the array one. We can have this temperature. Okay, and for array two, that is the unit sold. Okay. Now we have this correlation between these two is 0.28597. Okay. Now another useful example here also we can take the another theorem I just finish it, then I'll explain it later. Correlation of temperature and price of ice cream. Okay. Now again, correlation. Array one is the temperature, and the second array is the price of ice cream. Okay. Now here is the correlation function. Now why this correlation? I think you have the idea why this correlation. That's why I have just drafted another example. The subject one, that is age, and this is the glucose level. So as you can see, there is a correlation between age and the glucose level. As you can see, this is the age is 43, glucose level is 99. Age is 21, glucose level is 65. So if, as you can say, age is 59, it is glucose level is 81. So there is some relation between age and the glucose level. So we need to identify what is the correlation between the age and the glucose level. Okay, now obviously we are actually getting the values like this 0.9, 0.2. Okay, now whenever it is up to 0.1, that means it is close to one, that means it is having a tendency that it is a positive. That means if we're getting the positive value and it is close to one, then we can say this is having the correlation, it is increasing. Okay, and if it is minus, then we can say this is the correlation of the negative. So we can see in this particular case what will be the correlation between age and the glucose level. Okay, so we have this correlation of insert the correlation function. Okay, then array one, which is the x array, this is the age. Array two, which is the glucose level. So it is 0.5. First of all, 0.529 something. So first of all, it is clearly seen that it is a positive value, and it is close to, I mean, not one, it is the close to, I mean, 0.5 like this. So clearly we can have the conclusion that if age is increasing, then somehow the glucose level is also, if the statistics, if we have all the data like this, the glucose level is also increasing. So like this, you have to make the, you can say, decision, or you can say the you are going to analyze the whole data from this. Okay, so this is the correlation. Now sampling. So in the sampling, we have also the same data. I'm just doing it in the sample. So we have this periodic sampling and the random.
So your voice is not audible. Hello.
Arko sir, your voice is not audible.
Arko sir, I think there is an internet issue, I think.
Arko sir, your voice is not audible.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Now you
am I audible? Okay. So in the previous example, that is the correlation, we have just seen this correlation like this, and that is the value we have been here. Now I didn't show you, if you can do this in the data analysis tool, I mean from the data analysis tool pack. So in the tool pack also, now here we have the value correlation of temperature, correlation of temperature unit sold, and that is the temperature and price of the ice cream. Now what would happen if we do this one in the data analysis pack? We have the correlation. Click on this. Now in this particular case, the input range will be the entire. Okay, I'll just select the entire data as an input range. Okay, and it will be like levels in the first row, obviously, and the output range is somehow I'll just in here. Okay, so as you can see, the levels are not coming here. We need to match with this relation correlation, because we need to we have done it in the correlation function, and with this function it is not coming here, but it should come. We'll do once again. There is a correlation. Output range will be like see, from there I can see the output. Change it to the columns. So it's not giving the same output. Okay, but in the correlation you can have this one, but in the function it should give you the result same as we have done in the function. Okay, so this is what actually happens in correlation function. I'm just showing you, this is the correlation we have already done, but if you want to do this from here, you have to select the whole range. As you can see in here, okay, levels in the first row, and I didn't select the level, I think. So this will be selected, levels in the first row, columns will be there selected, output range will be like from here. So we are having this output range. Just select a particular cell, and if you press OK, now it is showing. The problem was I didn't select the whole thing. That's why it was not showing you the proper value. As you can see, the price of ice cream and the temperature of the ice cream, the unit sold. Okay, so here are the correlation of these two variables. So the price of ice cream with the temperature is 9614. So similar, we have the match. Okay, and the unit sold with the temperature, it is 0.28597. So this is a match. So there are two options, as I have already told you, whether you can use this fx or function, the function correlation, or I mean every statistical function is having their function in here, if that is done by the function like standard deviation, mean, median. Okay, and also you can do the data analysis pack. Okay, so again it is very important, as you have seen, that if in the correlation the mistake was I took this level in the first row, but I didn't select the level in the first row. Okay, I only selected the data. That's what the problem occurs, and I was not getting the proper result. Okay, so you should be very careful when you are selecting the data, whether it is only data or the data with the levels. Okay, so as we can see, so this is a perfect match. And here also, if you do the same thing, like you can do this, this is the correlation. If we do this thing, same analysis, I'm sure that will be giving the same result. So the correlation, let's do once again. This is the age and the glucose level. Okay, levels in the first row. Output range will be, I'll just delete the output range and putting it in here. Levels in the first row, it is selected. Now, okay, as you can see, we have our match. Okay. So glucose level with age will be like this. So this is the match. Okay. So next, I was just showing the sampling. Now, what is the sampling? One is periodic sampling and is random sampling. That means if this is a population, the theory is actually you can take the sample from any of the data. I mean, this we are having this data temperature. The periodic sampling, there should be a known period like 2 or 3, then we can take the data. And random sampling, there will be randomly choosing the data. Okay, now first of all, we'll see the periodic sampling. Go to the data analysis and find sampling in here. Here is the sampling. Okay, so again, it is asking for the input range. So input range, say for example, temperature, I'm taking as input range. Okay, again, I'll just do the mistake. It will be from temperature to this, and you have to click the levels. So you have the levels in there. Okay, now sampling method, periodic. If you choose the periodic, period will be, say for example, 2. Okay, next I'll show you the random. Output range is like this. Click on this and click on this cell, then click on okay. So we have the periodic sampling, like the period is 2. So second one is 26, third, fourth one is 35, then fourth, fifth one is 40. Okay, so this is what the periodic sampling is, if you want to the periodic sampling. Now the random sampling, go to the data analysis, find sampling, it is already selected. Okay, so this time also I'll take temperature or say unit sold. I'll just take unit sold. Okay, now here I'll take random sampling. Number of samples, say here I have only 7 data in here. Okay, now number of samples, if I say 4, and the output range will be starting from here, then click on okay. So we have random sampling like 10, 25, 12 and 10, because we have 10 2 times. So we don't have any kind of period in here. Okay, so this is the periodic sampling and the random sampling. Okay, Atul sir, any question is there? So I cannot see that.
Yes sir, we have like another question. How to interpret the table?
How to interpret tables? Interpret tables in where? I mean, please be specific.
If we have some kind of data analysis, for example, t-test tables are there, how to interpret them? How we should start?
Okay, so for example, if you want to do some testing like t-test, okay, or z-test. So if this is a table, we have the tables, but apply this, let's say, for example, take this one. Okay, go to data analysis, I'm not sure it will be applicable for this small data set or not. So variable one is range. First of all, let's try this variable. Like this is the variable range one, variable range two is the unit sold. Okay. Hypothesis mean difference. Give the value. I cannot assure that this table will be working or not. I can tick the levels also. Mean differences, say for example 2, and the output range will be from here. Okay, alpha is 0.5. So you can have this analysis in here, like the mean of this particular data, temperature is 33, variance is this. Unit sold is 16, total observation is 7, it is correct. And then hypothesis mean difference is 2, already have this 2, degree of freedom is 6. Okay, t stat is there, one tail, two tail. As you can see, this is the total result you can see. Okay, so this is for t test. Okay, paired two sample for means. This is how you can use any of the test in the data analysis pack, and you just try any test. First of all, you have to have the knowledge of what is this test. Okay, as you have already done the theoretical part, that is in the pen on paper, I think I'm sure you have done this part. And then this Excel, what is this doing? It is actually saving your time. First of all, that you don't need to write it down. You don't need a pen on paper, do the all these things. You just download, or you can create the data set and do the analysis whatever you want. Okay, for example, Z test. Okay, now here if you know all the parameters you are having in your data set. So in my data set, it is very small. It is only for an example I have just taken. Okay, and if you have all these parameters known, okay, then these tests are very easy to, you can say, accessible from Excel. Okay, variable one range, we can I'm just a dummy using this one variable one range. We can do this one. Variable two range also, we can do this one. This is only a quick test, okay? Nothing to compare, because in this kind of data set, which is not actually accurate, you might be having some kind of, wrong output. But I'll just show you how to do it. I'm sure you must have some data set with you. If you are doing research, you are actually doing this test on the proper on actual data set. So do this test in actual data set, and then it will be it giving you the exact result. Okay, for the variance, if it is known, you can use this one. So the output range, if I'm selecting this, variance one must be greater than 0. So you can this two. Okay, sorry. Give the random number. So here you can just see the result of Z test. Okay, so in this particular session, it is actually not possible to cover up all the session in a short period of time. As you can see, there are a lot of, you can say, test available in here. So ANOVA, single factor, two factor, correlation, covariance. So it is only a kind of overview how you can actually analyze that particular data set you are having with the help of Excel. And I'm sure you know this. Again, I'm showing this image to you because I think you know that this null hypothesis, how to do that, and how to do this test like t-square test, u-test, h-test, okay? It is according to the need, whatever model you are actually building, in that particular model, these tests are required, okay? So in this case also, there are a lot of, I mean, data analysis tool packs are available, like random number generation, regression analysis, which is very important. Regression, say we can also do the regression test here also, sampling. So t-test pair, t-test sample. So my motto is just to demonstrate you how you can do the advanced Excel research. I mean, Excel for the research purpose. So you have all the, you can say, tool pack you what you need. I'm just covering up the technical part, okay? So I'm not going into the mathematical part, only for consider demonstration. So I don't have this proper data set, only just a sample data set. I have only 7 or 8 number. That's why it might be looks odd that how you can correlate all those things, okay? But the thing is that I think you have some idea how to do the basic analysis and basic test in Excel, starting from the sum, okay? And I mean, there are a lot of tests available in here also. Like if you do the regression statistics is also there, I mean, regression test is also there. So this is how you can get the output, okay? So this is the beauty of Excel. And here in Excel, you can do all the, I mean, research purpose test and build the model, analyze your data, okay? So we have other tests also. Okay, so I think that is all for today, because it is not possible to cover up all the tests, because I'll be giving, I mean, taking these data only, and I'll be showing you the same results. But the results will be different according to the test. But I think I'm sure you have some idea on that, how to do this analysis test within the Excel. Okay. How to make a chart from pivot table. Okay, fine. First of all, I can see the question. Here is another example of pivot table. So any table, any chart is being created from a data. For example, I have sales, say for example, 20, 34, 46, 78, 56, and year. I think that is all known, 1990, okay, 1995, 2000, 2001, 2002. Now, if you want to make a chart, just select this, okay, go to insert, and then here are the charts available, okay? And here is also the pivot chart. So we are not actually using the pivot chart in here. But if you want to use any other chart, we have pie chart, part, pie chart, bar, line, okay? So you can have this all charts with you. There are a lot of charts available, okay? So you can do that. Now in this case, you are asking the, what is the pivot, how to create the pivot chart, okay? Now, this is the sales data. If I'm having, this is the data, it's available on internet, you can also download it. So insert the table, okay? This is the entire range is there. I'm selecting new worksheet. Now chart will be created, for example, say the product order date, okay, and the, you can say, quantity, sum of the quantity and order date is there, okay? Now here is the option for pivot chart. Okay, so as you can see, insert a pivot chart tied to the data in this pivot table. So you can click the chart, you can select the bar chart, or according to your need. Some of the quantity that will be clearly visible. Click on OK. Your chart is there. Based on the pivot table, based on the fields you have selected, your chart is ready. Okay. In this way, you can analyze whatever field you need, and you can create the chart, and you can demonstrate. Decorate the chart like what type of chart will be the color. You can say this is the data and the data points. Okay. You can also use this. You can say line. What are the actually the slope of this particular chart? You can analyze those things. Okay. So this is how a pivot table is done, a pivot chart is done, any normal chart is done, and all the other things. Okay. I think I have answered the question. Any Atul sir, anyone is having another question? Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
So anyone is having other question?
No, sir, these are all the questions which we have gathered till now. And thank you, sir, for giving us this wonderful information, which will definitely going to help us towards our future research activities, and for giving us your valuable time. And furthermore, I would like to thank all the attendees who have actively participated in today's workshop. And many of you have asked about the recording of these sessions. The recordings will be provided to only those candidates after the completion of this workshop who are having full attendance throughout the workshop. So you don't have to worry about we are recording these lectures, and make sure you have complete attendance during the workshop, and you can get these recordings later on. So Arko sir, once again, thank you all the attending participants who have joined in today's workshop. I would like to thank each one of you. Thank you, Arko sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. And thanks to all the participants, all the participants who are, have their time for this session. I'm sure you got something clue, some clue how to do the analysis part. That was my main target, that you must be aware of how to do the analysis part in the Excel. Okay, that is the main thing. So I think you have learned something, and please do let me know how you like the session. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. Atul, sir, I want to say something. If any candidate have doubt in future also, they can send to us, and definitely we will give you answer on through mail. If you have any problem, question problem in the registry, in the attendance link, you can call me in the on the WhatsApp, in the WhatsApp, and this is my number 9015863257. And on your registered email address, we will send you the tomorrow's event session. We will start it from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. Okay, and if I hope everyone get the link, attendance link for the today. Thank you, Atul sir, for the
thank you,
thank you, sir.